Hey everybody, today I have got an awesome clone video for you. I kind of just saw that Fragrance World has done a clone of one of my favorite designer fragrances, Armani Code ABSOLU. I do have the original, so I'm going to do some side-by-side comparisons. I actually have not opened this up yet. This is Armani Code ABSOLU, and so we're going to kind of experience this for the first time together. As I am opening up the box here, I want to ask you to consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done that yet. That's a little loud. And give the video a like. And also let me know, have you tried this one? What do you think? What do you think of the original? And I'll let you know if this clone's any good. Maybe you'll have to pick it up. So let's go ahead and get this thing open. You know, pretty simple presentation here. But I could really care less most of the time about what kind of box it's in or whatever. Fragrance World has really been impressing me over the past year, a little more than a year. You've got a little, I can smell it right away, right out of the box. Oh, it's leaking a little, that's why. That's not cool, it's leaking a lot actually. Oh, that's interesting. I mean, I don't know how much it has leaked, but definitely leaking, and it definitely smells like Armani Code ABSOLU. So there's the bottle. You've got that sort of gold frosted look like you have on the original, of course, black cap. So what I have is a little 10 mil decant here, a little travel spray. I'll show you that it is, you know, I don't know how well you can see that, but it is, you know, Code ABSOLU. I've probably got like, you know, 3 mil of this left or something. It's a great fragrance. I love it. I've tried to make it last. It's discontinued and I wasn't planning on picking up a bottle. I love this DNA, but I do have some things I think smell pretty similar. Namely, Salvatore Ferragamo Uomo Signature. I think actually has some real similarities to this one. There's some others as well, a little similarity with something like Halloween Man X or even Invictus Victory. So let's go ahead and try these. So what I'm gonna do first is spray on the Fragrance World. Usually with a clone fragrance, if I'm doing side by side, if I spray the original first, often a designer, especially a niche, will have higher quality oils. And once you smell that one, you can barely even smell a clone. So smelling a clone first is usually the way to go. So here we go. We'll do 3 sprays on my arm. I don't know if you can see how wet that is, but it is definitely leaked. I have to figure out what the deal is. Man, this leaked a lot. I don't know if you can see how wet my finger is there, but it has a problem for sure. Man. All right, so. So right away, I'm getting that vanilla tonka bean vibe. You've got a little bit of spiciness, also a little bit of freshness. I do actually prefer this one over the Ferragamo Uomo Signature. Something about there's a liveliness, almost an effervescence to this fragrance that I don't get with the other ones that I mentioned. That leathery vibe is one of my favorite things about ABSOLU, Code ABSOLU, and I don't get that as much in this one, but I haven't worn the, I think I wore this maybe last week. So let's go ahead and try the original, and we'll go ahead and see how it compares. These are little sprays here. All right, let's see how the original compares. That's so funny. You know, what I said a minute ago was sometimes whenever you spray a designer first and then you go to the clone, usually the designer is stronger or higher quality. You can't smell the clone. I'm almost having the opposite experience right now. It's so funny. It's like smelling the clone first set the DNA in my mind. And now this one, maybe it's because the atomizer isn't spraying out as much. Let me give a little more on this thing. See how that does. That's better. Yeah, they're very close. I mean, it smells amazing. The fragrance world smells really good. It's a really good clone. There is something, to be honest, a little more natural smelling about the Armani. It's not like it's a very natural fragrance profile, but what I mean is, you know, not quite as synthetic, if that's the word. There's just something with a little more texture. That's a good way to say it with the Armani. I might cut some of this out, you know, the back and forth, but there is so much similarity. It's really hard to tell them apart. And I want to renege a little bit on what I said about the leather vibe. They're actually very similar. I really get the leather more in the mid of this fragrance, and it's whenever I'm wearing it, you know, 3-4 hours in, I'll start to get more wafts of that leather or suede, I think is the actual note. And so I don't know what to say other than this is really close, side by side, like, you know, I almost can't, you know, I don't know. I could barely tell a difference. It's like the sweetness is hitting me a little bit different. Maybe I could say that the Armani maybe is just a hair more bubblegummy sweet. And then this one doesn't have any of that bubblegummy, but I'm really reaching here for something to, you know, point to as being different. So I got to tell you, this is a good clone. I love this fragrance profile. I'm going to wear the heck out of this. I'm really, really hoping. I got this from Fragrance Buy. I'm hoping that it's not leaking around the collar. Maybe it's just in shipping, you know, that maybe it leaked. It got banged around a bunch, and I don't know how it would leak. It's pretty unusual. I'll do, you know, if I cover this in another video, I'll update about whether or not the leaking has become an issue. But man, great clone from Fragrance World, side by side. It's pretty tough to tell them apart. I need obviously to do a full wearing of this one, and then within a day or two, do a full wearing of the Armani, just to kind of get the full, you know, performance metrics, the longevity, projection, sillage, all of that, as well as some of the finer nuances of the dry down and, you know, the mid and all those kind of things. So very good so far, about 5 minutes into the fragrance. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little tag at the end of this in a couple hours after a little bit of the dry down starts to come out. I can't go like 4 or 5 hours, but I can go a couple hours. I'll be able to do that. So thank you for watching. I'll be back in a minute with a little more info. All right, people, I am back. It's a little more on towards the evening now. I've had the clone Harmony Code Absolute on my left arm. On my right arm, I've got the original Armani Code Absolute. I've actually had my sleeves down for most of the afternoon, early evening, so I just now rolled them up. Kind of trying to preserve whatever's in there, and I'm going to go ahead and compare, you know, early dry down, I guess you could say. So they are still very close. Yeah, they're really close. I mean, I don't know what else to say. I can't pick out any major differences to highlight to you. There is something that is a little bit different between the two. It's just a little bit hard to put into words. Maybe there's something a little more, maybe a little more textured or something like that to the Armani, but they actually are pretty close. So nothing major to report a couple hours in, as far as, you know, the clone goes way far away from the original. I am going to need to spend some time with these. I'll get a couple full wearings in this week, and I'll be back In a video soon, I'll include this clone in at least a list to kind of give you an update. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments, have you tried this one? What do you think? I'd love to actually hear your thoughts on it. Give the video a like if you liked it, and remember to subscribe. I'm Justin. This is Siage Scents. Thanks so much for watching.